789, my birthday special for Frankie. Playing Jeopardy 2nd edition for the PlayStation in this one.
Let's see if you like these first round categories.
Let's see what we have.
Our Earth. Writers named William. Early in their careers. Pop quiz. Sports and leisure. And our last category is finish the proverb. Player one, what will it be?
Sports and leisure 100.
Important races of this animal, first held in the 1860s, in Canada's Plate and the Belmont Stakes. Player one.
What is horse?
That's right.
All right, same category for 200.
In the 1800s, these balls were stuffed with feathers, molded of gutta percha, and wound with rubber. Player three.
Golf balls?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, player three.
Pop quiz. For 100, please.
Country in which you would find the Book of Kells. Player three.
What is... Player?
Well done, yes.
Okay.
Quiz for 200.
In 1943, the Supreme Court said that those whose religious beliefs prohibit it don't have to recite this pledge.
What is the Pledge of Allegiance? Alright, how about sports and leisure for 300?
This clue murder weapon could also light up the tables in the dining room. Player two.
What is the lamp?
Good answer, but sorry. That's wrong. Nobody?
The candlestick. Oh, yes.
It's the foul nickname of the University of Oregon's athletic teams. Anyone at all?
The Oregon Ducks. Oh, yeah. Sports and Leisure 500.
In a series at Marvel Comics, his daughter May has taken up his crime-fighting ways as Spider-Girl. Player one.
Who's Peter Parker? Pop quiz for 300.
Octane is a colorless, flammable hydrocarbon found in this liquid. You should have its number. Layer two.
Is gas.
Exactly. Layer two. Let's try Writer's name, William. For 100, Alex.
He was baptized in the parish church of Stratford-on-Avon, April 26, 1564.
Layer two.
William Shakespeare.
That's it.
And that was
the
one.
Name William. For 200, please.
A Rose for Emily is a well-known short story by this author of The Sound and the Fury.
Layer three.
William Faulkner.
Right you are.
Our Earth for 100.
This outer part of the Earth shares its name with the outer part of a pond.
What is the crust?
Layer one. That's it. Layer one, what would it be?
From the Latin for track, it's the path of the Earth around the Sun.
What is orbit?
Layer one. Right you are.
This satellite of the Earth is a whopping 2,160 miles in diameter. A lot bigger than it looks.
Layer two?
The moon?
Well done, yes.
Oh, yeah.
Layer two. Finish the proverb. For 100, please.
Be it ever so humble, there's no place like...
Layer one? That's it. Layer one, your turn.
The highest temperature ever recorded on Earth was 136 degrees Fahrenheit at Al-Aziziyah on this continent.
Layer one. That's not right.
Nah, not Asia.
Nobody?
Africa.
Some theorize that the Earth once had just one of these bodies of water, called Pampalasa.
Layer three?
An ocean.
Layer three, what will it be?
Early in their careers. For 100, please.
Rhea Perlman fell for him when she saw him play a demented stable boy in a play called The Shrinking Bride.
Layer two.
Danny DeVito.
That's it.
That was the one.
Your choice, player two.
Early in their careers. For 200, please. Rent Psycho 2, and you'll see Dennis Franz as Toomey, who runs this infamous establishment as an adult motel.
Anyone at all?
The Bates Motel. Ah.
Writer's name, William. For 300. In 1996, this exorcist author published Demons 5, Exorcist Nothing, a favorite.
Layer two.
William Blatty.
Exactly.
That was the one.
Give me writer's name William for 400. His newspaper column on language has been syndicated around the world. Player two.
William Sapphire?
That's right. Writer's name William. For 500, Alex. In 1990's Darkness Visible, this Sophie's Choice author wrote of his struggle with depression. Player two.
William Styron.
Exactly.
I've never heard of him.
Early in their careers. For 300, Alex. While a student at Oxford, Hugh Grant tried out for this role in the film Greystone. Anyone at all?
Tarzan.
Finish the proverb for 200, Alex. Pride goeth before a...
What is fall? Oh, yeah.
Pop quiz for 400. Manly men know it's the main androgen. Layer three.
Testosterone?
That's it.
Mm-hmm.
If you would, layer three.
Pop quiz for 500.
Deneb is the brightest star in this constellation whose name means swan. Anyone at all?
And the constellation is Cygnus.
Finish the proverb for 300, Alex.
A bird in the hand is worth two in the...
What is bush?
Player one. Exactly.
Finish the proverb for 400.
Your choice.
What is fonder?
Layer one. Definitely.
All right, I'm in second place. Let's finish off the category.
Brevity is the soul of... Layer two.
Wit.
That's right.
All right, two clues left. Answer, Daily Double.
Daily Double.
Took a while to find it.
Player two, your wager, please.
2,200, and he's going to risk 1,200 of it.
George Cukor directed Red Line's 1981 film debut, and this Catherine's 1932 debut.
Oh, I think I know this one.
Player two?
No, I was thinking Katharine Hepburn, and it was indeed Hepburn.
And the final answer of the round. Alan Ladd appeared as a reporter in his 1941 Orson Welles masterpiece. Player three?
Citizen Kane?
Right, you are.
Yes. And that's the end of the Jeopardy round.
Player one, you're not far off the lead now. Player two, you're in last place.